गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर डूइंग लेसन टू न्यूट्रिशन इन एनिमल्स. वी आर डूइंग एक्सरसाइज ए, आंसर इन डिटेल. यस्टरडे वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड क्वेश्चन नंबर वन एंड वी वर डूइंग क्वेश्चन नंबर टू. ए बी सी पार्ट वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड ऑफ क्वेश्चन नंबर टू. सो टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद द डी पार्ट ऑफ क्वेश्चन टू. नाउ चिल्ड्रन, सो स्टार्ट विद क्वेश्चन नंबर टू डी.
Now the part number D is liver. Now what is a liver? First you have to see what is a liver. Liver is the largest gland of the body. Don't forget beta, this is the question which is mostly asked in the examinations, that which is the largest gland in the body. So answer is liver is the largest gland in the body. It is reddish brown in color. And it is located in the upper part of the abdomen on the right side. Functions of the liver is to secrete bile juice, which helps in the digestion of fat, in which fats can be broken down into fatty acids and glycerol. Fatty acids and glycerol are simpler substances in which fats are being broken down in the digestion process. Children, this is the diagram of the liver. The color of the liver is reddish brown. The color shown here is reddish brown. So you have to color the liver in the same way. And below the liver, there is shown a structure, green structure, which is called as gallbladder or gallbladder. And there are some veins and arteries shown, which are portal vein, hepatic vein, hepatic artery, and one duct is shown, common bile duct. Now children, moving on to the next part, E, pseudopodia. So what are pseudopodia? Pseudopodia are present in a microorganism, amoeba. Amoeba is a microscopic single-celled organism found in pond water. It is simple organisms having an irregular shape. Amoeba is capable of constantly changing its shapes and position. It gives out one or more finger-like projections called false feet or pseudopodia. Singular of the pseudopodia is pseudopodium. Now the functions of pseudopodia include, number one, locomotion. The cytoplasm flows and fills into the network fibers which are present in the cell wall. This enables them to move. The pseudopod extends from amoeba and the amoeba flows into that pseudopod and helps it to change the place. So pseudopodia help in the locomotion of the amoeba. Number second is phagocytosis. So what is phagocytosis? Phagocytosis is engulfing of the other organism. Now children, question number third is, how does digestion takes place in ruminants? Explain with the help of diagram. First children, you have to see what are ruminants. You all know that what are ruminants? The grass-eating animals are called as ruminants. You may also define ruminants as the animals who chew cud are known as ruminants. The grass-eating animals you all know children, food of grass eating animals consists of plant materials, particularly grass. Grass is rich in cellulose. Cellulose is a type of carbohydrate. Many animals, including humans, cannot digest cellulose. But grass eating animals have a unique character of digesting cellulose. They can easily digest cellulose. In fact, the grass-eating animals quickly swallow the fodder and store in a separate part of the stomach called rumen. In the rumen, food is partially digested. The partially digested food is called cud. The cud is then brought to the mouth in small lumps and chewed. This process of chewing the cud is called rumination, and the animals are called ruminants. During rumination, cud mixes with saliva and becomes pulpy or semi-solid paste. After chewing, the pulpy food is passed to the rest of the stomach. Now, do you know, children, stomach in ruminants is different from the human stomach. In ruminants, stomach has four chambers: rumen, reticulum, omasum and abomasum. The first chamber of a ruminant stomach is the rumen. It is the largest chamber. Food is stored here and digestion of cellulose also takes place here. From the rumen, the food enters the second chamber called the reticulum. In fact, the rumen and reticulum are closely associated and their contents mix freely. In these two chambers, the food is partially digested and converted into a soft pulp called the cud. The pulpy food, which is brought back to the mouth when the animal is resting. After chewing, the food from the mouth is pushed into the third chamber called the omasum. It is the smallest chamber. From here, food enters the fourth chamber called the abomasum. This is the true stomach. Digestive juice is secreted here to help in the process of digestion. From the fourth chamber, the food enters the small intestine. Absorption of nutrients takes place in the small intestine, as in the humans also. Write the answer. Ruminants. None of the animal can digest cellulose, which is a major component of the food eaten by herbivores. The plant-eating animals digest their food in two steps. Their stomach is divided into four chambers: rumen, reticulum, omasum and abomasum. First of all, half-chewed food is swallowed and it then goes from mouth to the rumen, the first chamber of the stomach. Here it is acted upon by bacteria. These microorganisms digest the cellulose. Here also a picture of the digestive system of ruminant is given. You have to draw this diagram on the left hand side of the notebook. Now again we will continue with our answer. The half digested food goes to the second chamber, the reticulum. The name of the second chamber is reticulum. From the reticulum, the food is sent back to the mouth as cud to be chewed again. Chewing of the cud is called rumination, and such animals are called ruminating animals or ruminants. Cow, goat, buffalo, sheep, bison, etc. are good examples of ruminating animals. After digestion and absorption, nutrients from food are taken into the cells in all parts of the body. The cells oxidize the food to release energy. This is the picture of a digestive system of ruminant. You have to draw this picture in your notebook on the blank page on the left hand side of the answer 3. The stomach in ruminant is 4 chambered. Number 1 is rumen, reticulum, omasum and abomasum. These are the 4 chambers of a stomach of a ruminant. The first chamber of ruminant stomach is known as rumen. And the second chamber is known as reticulum. Third chamber is omasum. And the fourth chamber is abomasum. Abomasum is the true stomach of ruminants. Digestive juices is secreted here in the abomasum to help in the process of digestion. From the fourth chamber, means abomasum, the food passes through to the intestine, small intestine, and where the absorption of nutrients takes place. Now children, how the process of digestion takes place? The first chamber of a ruminant stomach is the rumen. It is the largest chamber. Food is stored here and digestion of cellulose also takes place. Grass-eating animals quickly swallow the fodder or the food they are eating and store it in a separate part of the stomach called ruminant. In the rumen, food is partially digested. The partially digested food is called cud. From the rumen, the food enters the second chamber called the reticulum. Rumen and reticulum are closely associated and their contents mix freely. In these two chambers, the food is partially digested and converted into a soft pulp called the cud. The pulpy food is brought back to the mouth when the animal is resting. After chewing the food from the mouth, it is pushed into the third chamber called the omasum. It is the smallest chamber. From here, food enters the fourth chamber called the abomasum. Digestive juice is secreted in the fourth chamber, which help in the process of digestion. From the fourth chamber, the food passes to the small intestine, where absorption of the nutrients takes place. So this is the process of digestion of food in ruminants. So children, what is your assignment for today? So your assignment for today is do all the questions answer in your notebook. Okay, thank you children.